Hi friends, welcome back to CADable. This is Engineer Ibrahim Omer, and in this tutorial we'll practice this feature, move copy bodies in Solidworks. This would be practice exercise 32 of this playlist, and I will provide its file in the description link so you can download it from there and you can practice. So let's go to your new, select part and select OK. First of all, as usual, I will change my background to plain white and I will set my units to mmgs. Let's draw this part. So let's go to here Solidworks, and I will choose front plane, select sketch, and let's say I will start with this one, center point straight slot. Let's dimension this. Let's say this one 40 millimeters, and let's say this dimension is 20 millimeters. Now you can see that sketch is fully defined. So I will exit this sketch and I'll go to your features, swept boss, and here I will use circular profile and 10 millimeter. So I will select this one and select OK. Now here you should notice one very important thing, that is we only model this part, okay, and the rest will be modeled by using move body command or linear pattern or mirror. Okay, so let's go to here this part again, and now I can use move copy bodies command. So let's go to here insert features, and here you'll find this command, move copy bodies. So I will select this one and copy, and here I will translate this one. I will rotate this one. Here you have three options, either you can translate, rotate or constrain. You cannot use rotate and translate simultaneously. Okay, you can use either rotate or translate. So let's go to here rotate. So I will rotate it in x direction 90 degrees, and I will select OK. Now I will use again this command. So let's go to here insert again, features, move copy bodies, and I will select this one and I will drag this in the x direction. You can see this preview, and here I will uncheck this one and I will drag this to maybe somewhere here. Okay, select OK. Let's say I can drag it to maybe here. Okay, that's fine. Now I can use let's say linear pattern command. So let's go to here linear pattern command, and for the direction, let's say I can choose let's say right plane, and I will select here bodies, not features, because these two chains are separate solid bodies. So first I will select this one and then I will select this one, and I can use this spacing 90 millimeters, and I will select OK. Now I can use let's say mirror command to mirror these three onto here. So let's go to here mirror, and for the plane I will use this one, right plane, and here I will use bodies to mirror, not features to mirror or faces to mirror, because these four are separate solid bodies. You can see here as well. So I will select separately. I'll go to your bodies to mirror. I will select this one, this one, this one, and okay. So that's how you can make these assemblies in Solidworks very easily using this command, move copy bodies, and here you can see that we have seven separate solid bodies, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Lastly, I will apply some appearance to this chain. So let's go to your appearance, and let's say I'll go to your metal, and under metal I'll go to your, let's say, bronze, or maybe brass, or let's say copper, and I will apply this appearance to this chain, and I will use perspective, and I will use this one shaded. So that's how you can use this feature move copy bodies in SolidWorks. That's it for today's tutorial. I hope you like it, and if you have any questions, any queries related to this tutorial or any other tutorial in my list, you can ask in comment section. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe to our channel for more informative and interesting projects. Thank you.